Hello everyone, welcome to our channel Vivan Education. Today we are going to discuss about class 10th polynomials. So very important topic. So today we are going to discuss about 4 marks questions. Okay, so we are having 3 types of questions to get in examinations. First one is about divisions process or nothing but divisions algorithm. And second one is about how to find a quadratic and cubic polynomials. And the last one is about graphical method. So these three questions having to get a 4 marks question in board exams. Okay, So today we are going to discuss about the first topic is about division algorithm. So what indicates that division algorithm? First we will see. We'll go with the general examples first. So suppose I'm giving a question as 25 divided by 4. How will you divide? 25 divided by 4 means 25. It will take 4 and 4 6 are 24. If you do subtraction, 5 minus 4 is 1. We got a remainder is 1. So what indicates here 4, 25, 6 and 1? Yes, you know here 25 indicates the dividend, 4 indicates the divisor and 6 indicates the quotient and 1 indicates the remainder. Simply we can write here 25 is equals to 4 into 6, 4 into 6 plus 1 indicates 4 times of 6 is 24. Plus 1 is equals to 25. Yes, 25 is equals to 25. We got the same answer. So, it is a correct one. So, hence, what we can conclude from this one? We can write as dividend. Yes, dividend is equals to divisor. Divisor into quotient plus remainder. The formula, so which we learned till 5th or 6th class, we learned this formula. What is the formula? Dividend is equals to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Yes, so we are applying here algorithm called Euclid's division algorithm. If you apply Euclid's division algorithm to the normal division, then we'll get the division algorithm. Division algorithm. So what it states? So means here if p of x and g of x, if p of x and g of x are any two polynomials with g of x not equals to 0, this g of x not equals to 0, then we can find polynomials of q of x and R of x. If p of x and g of x are any two polynomials and this g of x should not equal to 0, then we can find the polynomials called q of x and r of x. Nothing but we can written as this one, p of x equals to g of x into q of x plus r of x. So simply, sorry, again I will write p of x equals to q of x into g of x plus r of x. Here p of x is called normal as p of x is called as a dividend, q of x is called a quotient, g of x is called a divisor and r of x called is a remainder. So g of x into q of x or q of x into g of x both are same only. So the formula we can written as p of x equals to g of x into q of x plus r of x. Okay, is it clear? P of x is called a dividend, g of x is called a divisor, q of x is called a quotient and r of x is called the remainder. Yes, is it clear? And where compulsory here, remainder. So r of x, maybe you will get the 0 or r of x compulsory less than the degree of g of x. This is a condition, otherwise it will be wrong. because and condition is a remainder should may you will get zero or remainder compulsory should less than the degree of g of x if g of x not equal to zero if r of x is not equal to zero. So this is a condition. So once we'll observe here p of x and g of x are in two polynomials with g of x not equal to zero. So what will happen if g of x becomes zero? So we'll see. Suppose we'll see general example here. Suppose 25 divided by 0. So what will do 0 with 25? Is it possible here? So it's not to define. So always the g of x should not equal to 0. Okay. So this is about the general introduction about the division algorithm. So by taking one question. So and one more thing here, we are having three different types of question. One is a direct question. And when given roots. And when given, when we had to find the g of x or p of x. How to find the p of x or g of x? Then this is one question having. When given roots, how will you find the divisions? And last one is about the direct method. So we'll see one by one. Okay, na? So first we'll go with the direct method. How will you do? How will you find the direct method by using division algorithm? Okay, so I'm taking one textual question as a so divide a question is a divide 3x square minus x cube minus 3x plus 5 by x minus 1 minus x square. So this is a question. Now check it here. So divide 3x square minus x cube minus 3x plus 5 by x minus 1 minus x square. So we'll do solution for this one. So first step is how to find the quotient and remainder means. First we have to write the both dividend and divisor decreasing order of the degrees. So first we have to arrange the degrees in a decreasing order or a descending order. Okay, so first we'll indicate this one. So here, what is the dividend here? Dividend is equals to 3x square minus x cube minus 3x plus 5. Now, we had to arrange the degrees according to the decreasing order. So, that is x cube is at minus x cube plus 3x square then minus 3x plus 5. Now, if you see here, degree 3, 2, and 1 and constant degree is 0. Yes, it's in a decreasing order. Complete a dividend. How will you get the first term of q of x means we had to divide the highest degree of the dividend with the highest degree of the divisor. Now check it here. What is the highest degree of the dividend? Minus x cube. What is the highest degree of divisor? Minus x square. So minus x cube I'm writing as x square into x. This one with a minus x square. Same. Now minus x square cancel. Then what is the first term of q of x is x. Now we have to remind. Now we have to remind one thing that this divisor all terms we have to divide with the q of x. Now minus x square into x is becomes minus x cube. Now it is completed. Now what is second term in divisor x is z. Plus and plus is plus only. X into x becomes x square plus x square. Last term is minus 1 is z. Minus 2 plus is minus. 1 into x is 1x. Minus 1x or x. No. The thing is that we have to cancel now. So we have to interchange the symbols. So what is the use of interchange the symbol means to cancel will change the symbols. Now here what is the symbol is there? Minus is z. If you change the minus becomes plus. Plus becomes minus. Minus becomes plus. Now see. Minus x square, this is now plus x square, both will be cancel. Now come to the second one. Now here, this is not plus, now minus, because we have changed the symbols. Now plus minus means we have to do subtraction. 3 minus 1 is what? 2. 2 x square, compared to 1 and 3, 3 greater is the plus symbol. So no need to keep plus here. And now coming to here, minus plus subtraction. So 3 minus 1 is 2x. Now coming to 3 and 1, 3 having greater. So which symbol is there? Minus. So minus. Okay, now what is the carry is there here? 5. I'm taking carry plus 5. Now again, to get the second term of Q of X, second term of Q of X, again go with the highest degree of dividend. Now what is the highest term of the dividend is here? 2x square. Divide with the highest degree of the divisor. What is the divisor highest degree here? Minus x square. X square will be cancelled. Then 2 by minus 1. So answer is what? Minus 2. What is the second term of Q of X is now here? Minus 2. Now just again remind, just remove x here. Now with minus 2, you have to multiply total term of the divisor. Now check it here. Minus into minus becomes plus. 2 into x square? 2x square. Plus 2x square or 2x square both are same. Second one. Plus into minus is minus. 2 into x is 2x. Completed. Now coming to third one. Minus into minus is plus. 1, 2 is 2. Completed. Again we have to change the symbols. Plus is here. Plus becomes minus. Minus becomes plus. Plus becomes minus. Now see, on plus minus order will be cancelled. And here also minus plus will be cancelled. Or simply 2 minus 2 is 0. Or 2 minus 2 is 0. So instead of 0, just I am doing cancellation here. Now this is what? Minus 2. Because we have changed the symbols here, right? Now 5 minus 2 is what? 3. So therefore what we can write here? Therefore Q of X. What is the Q of X we got here? X minus 2 and R of X equals to 3. So this is about, this is the direct method of the division. First method is the direct method. So to get the Q of X, just we have to remind how will you get means highest degree of the dividend by highest degree of the divisor. And one more thing you have to remind is what? First we had to arrange the degrees in a standard form. Means we had to arrange the degrees in decreasing order, big to small. Is it clear everyone? This is the first method of the division. Second method is about when given zeros. When given zeros, how will you find? We'll see here. So next the question is obtain all the zeros of 3x to the power of 4 plus 6x cube minus 2x square minus 10x minus 5. If 2 of its zeros are root 5 by 3 and minus root 5 by 3. So the question is obtain all other zeros. He given 2 zeros. We have to find the other 2 zeros because degrees 4 is there. So he given 2 zeros. We have to find the other 2 zeros. Yes, again 3x to the power of 4 plus 6x cube minus 2x square minus 10x minus 5. If 2 of its zeros are given as root 5 by 3 and minus root 5 by 3. Okay, so we'll do here solution. So what is the given polynomial? Nothing but this is what? P of x is given as 3x to the power of 4 plus 6x cube minus 2x square minus 10x minus 5. Here, no need to arrange in standard form because already degrees in 4, 3, 2, 1, 0 form is there. So no need to arrange in order again. Already it is in standard form. Now, zeros given as zeros are what? Root 5 by 3 and minus root 5 by 3. That indicates what? X equals to root 5 by 3 and x equals to minus root 5 by 3. So considering zeros are x equals to. Then becomes what? X plus root 5 by 3 into this minus becomes plus and plus becomes minus. That indicates what? X minus root 5 by 3 equals to 0. Now in the form of a plus b into a minus b formula, a square minus b square. X into x is x square minus root a into a is a only. Nothing but 5 by 3 equals to 0. So again, if you do b into b, it becomes b square. Nothing but root 5 by 3 whole square. Square root will be cancelled. But already having root, root b into root b is b only. Nothing but 5 by 3 only. So if you do, it becomes what? 3 into x square is 3x square minus 5. So 3x square minus 5 equals to 0. So with 3x square minus 5, we had to divide this one. Okay. So just I am considering the G of X as a 3x square minus 5. Okay, or else if you do directly, if you won't take 0, then you can take x square minus 5 by 3. With this also, we get the same answer. If you take equals to 0, we had to divide with 3x square minus 5. If you not take 0 here, just divide with x square minus 5 by 3. Then also, we get the same answer. Okay, now we got the g of x. What is the g of x we got here? 3x square minus 5. And what is the p of x is here? 3x to the power of 4. Plus 6x cube minus 2x square minus 10x minus 5. Okay. So here I am doing space under here. So we know how to get the first term of q of x, highest degree of the dividend by highest degree of the divisor. That indicates what? 3x to the power of 4 by 3x square. Highest degree by highest degree. Dividend by divisor. So this one I am writing as 3x square into x square by 3x square. So x square into x square becomes x power 4. We know a power m into a power n is equal to a power m plus n. 2 plus 2 is 4. 3x square will be cancelled. Then what is the first term of q of x is x square. X square. Again I am reminding. So with these two terms we have to multiply the q of x. Now 3x square into 3x square becomes 3x to the power of 4. Clear? Then second term what is there here? Minus 5 is there. Minus into plus is minus. 5 into x square is 5x square. So minus 5x square. X square term down only I am writing the x square term. Cube not there means you can take 0 plus or minus 0 you can take. Because 0 it won't change the values, right? Chalo, now the step is we have to change the symbols. Plus is there. Plus becomes minus. Plus becomes minus. Minus becomes plus. Now, 3 minus 3 is 0, nothing but a plus minus will be cancelled and a 6 plus 0 or 6 minus 0 is 6 only. So, what you will get here? 6x cube. Now, coming to here, this is what on a plus. Plus minus alternate means we have to do subtraction. 5 minus 2 is 3. 3x square. But coming to 2 and 5, which is greater 5? 5 having which symbol now? Plus, because we have changed the symbols, right? So, plus 5, nothing but what you will get here? Plus 3x square. Then, what is the carry you will get here? Minus 10x. Okay. Now coming to here. Again, to get the second term of the q of x, second term of q of x, highest degree of the dividend by highest degree of the divisor. So, 6x cube by 3x square. So, this one I am writing as 3x square into 2x. 3 to the 6 and x square into x becomes x cube by 3x square. These two will be cancelled. Then what is the second term of the q of x is 2x. Nothing but plus 2x. Now again just remove this one. With the divisor we had to multiply this one. 3 to the 6. X into x square is x cube. Nothing but 6x cube. Now this is minus is there. Minus into plus becomes minus. 5 to the 10x. Minus 10x. X term down. X term square not there. You can take plus or minus 0. It won't change the value. Now we had to change the symbols. Plus becomes minus. Plus becomes minus. Minus becomes plus. Alternate. 6 minus 6 is 0. This is plus 10 now. Plus 10 minus will be 0 or cancel. Now 3 plus 0 is 3 only. 3x square. And the carry is what is there here? Minus 5. I am writing as it is. Now we had to do the. We had to get the third term of q of x. So what is the highest degree? 3x square of the dividend by divisor again 3x squares. So, same terms cancel, the q of x will be 1. So, third term will be plus 1. So, 3x square terms of 1 is 3x square and minus into plus becomes minus 5 ones are 5. Got. Now, change the symbols again. Plus becomes minus, minus becomes plus. Plus minus will be 0, minus plus will be 0. So, the remainder is got 0. Yes, we got the remainder is 0. But in the question what he asked, obtained all the zeros, sir. He given two zeros given. We had to find the other two zeros. So how will you get the other two zeros means we had to split the q of x. If you split q of x, then you will get the other two zeros. Now see here, what is the q of x is there? Here I am doing. So finding in a splitting method, x square plus 2x plus 1. Okay, so 1 is there. If you multiply two numbers, 1 into 1 means you will get 2. You had to get 1. If you add those two numbers, you have to get a 2. What will tell me you have to get? Okay, na? So a into b. If you do a into b, you have to get 1. If you do a plus b, you have to get 2 middle term. So we know 1 1s are 1. Sorry, my phone is tracked. I didn't show that one. I didn't already this one. So if you multiply any two numbers, you have to get 1. If you add, you have to get 2. So I took here x and x because x plus x is a 2x. X into x becomes a x square. Right? In these two, I took here x as a common. X into x is x square plus x 1s are x. Now, again in these two, taking 1 as a common factor, then you will get the same term here. So, because of 1 into x is 1x plus 1 1s are 1. So, this is unfortunate, I didn't see my phone. It is tracked. So, that's why I already done. Okay, na? Don't mind. Now, see, in these two are having common. So, I'm taking x plus 1 as a common factor. And the remaining what is here? Again also, x plus 1 is equal to 0. And because what x plus 1 we have to equate it to 0. And x plus 1 also equal to 0. X equals to plus 1 becomes minus 1 and x equals to plus 1 becomes minus 1. So the other two zeros of the given polynomial is a minus 1 and a minus 1. So therefore the all zeros are root 5 by 3 comma minus root 5 by 3 comma minus 1 and minus 1 are the four zeros of the given polynomial. This is about the second method. So, first one is about the direct method. This one is about the when given zeros. Okay. So, direct and when given roots. And how to find the p of x or g of x. Okay. This is the last question we are having. So, the question is a textual question. On dividing x cube minus 3x square plus x plus 2 by a polynomial g of x, the quotient and remainder were x minus 2 and minus 2x plus 4 respectively. Find g of x. Okay, this is the question. Come on. So again, I will write here. So on dividing. On dividing x cube minus 3x square plus x plus 2 by a polynomial g of x. By g of x. The quotient, that means q of x is equals to x minus 2 and g of x is given as minus 2x plus 4. Then we had to find g of x is the question. Once again I'm reading. On dividing this polynomial x cube minus 3x square plus x plus 2 by a polynomial g of x, q of x and g of x given as x minus 2 and minus 2x plus 4 respectively. Then we had to find what? We had to find the g of x. So if you observe here, already these are given in a standard form. 3, 2, 1, 0 and 1, 0 and 1, 0. So clear. So again, we'll write given solution. Given p of x. P of x is what is it here? X cube minus 3x square plus x plus 2. And q of x is given as x minus 2. And g of x, so this is what r of x, remainder given. R of x is equals to minus 2x plus 4. Then what do you have to find? G of x. Yes, this is a question is equals to what? Yes, we know division algorithm. So what the division algorithm says? Dividend is equals to divisor into quotient plus remainder. According to the Euclid's algorithm, we know p of x is equals to g of x into q of x plus r of x. This is a division algorithm. Just once we will replace given polynomials in this algorithm. So what is the p of x given as here? X cube minus 3x square plus x plus 2 is equals to g of x. G of x given? No, we had to find g of x as this. Into q of x given as x minus 2. Then plus remainder. What is the remainder given as? Minus 2x plus 4. Yes, is it okay? Yes? No. What will do means? So x cube minus 3x square plus x plus 2. Remainder transposing to the LHS side. So minus 2x becomes plus 2x plus 2 becomes minus 4 is equals to g of x into x minus 2. Is it clear? So r of x, I am bringing it to the LHS side. This implies x cube minus 3x square. Now see here, 2x plus x is what? 3x plus 3x. Constant plus 4 minus 2. Plus minus alternate subtraction added to 4 minus 2 is 2. And a big number having minus symbol minus is equals to g of x into x minus 2. Yes. Then what we have to find in the question? We have to find the g of x. So from this, what we can write here? G of x equals to x cube minus 3x square plus 3x minus 2 by multiplication becomes a division. So x minus 2. If you divide these two, x cube minus 3x square plus 3x minus 2 by x minus 2, then what you will get here? G of x. Yes, already we done about already we done these type of divisions in the previous one here. Okay, so again, we'll find the g of x. Chalo, come on, last sum. So g of x is what is it here? X minus 2. To find g of x, so now you have to think, this is a dividend, it is a divisor. So here, x cube minus 3x square plus 3x minus 2. We know how to get the q of x here. First means highest degree of the dividend by divisor. So what is it here? X cube there. So x cube by here x. X cube, I am writing now, x square into x by x. X, x will be cancelled. X square. So first term, what you got here? X square. Then x into x square is x cube. Now minus is there. Minus into plus minus. So minus 2 into x square is minus 2x square. Got. Now what you do? We have to change the symbols. Plus becomes minus. Minus becomes plus. Plus minus will be cancelled. Now it will be what? Plus 2. 3 minus 3 is 1. Nothing but 1x square or x square. 2, 3 greater 3 is there. Symbol is minus, is there minus. Now what is the carry we are getting here? Plus 3x. Again, here what is the greatest term here in dividend? Minus x square. On divisor here, x is there. So x square I am writing as minus x into x by x. Cancel. So what is the second term of the divisor is what is there? Well, quotient is what? Minus x. Minus x. Minus plus into minus is minus. X into x is x square. Now here second one. Minus into minus becomes plus. 2 into x is 2x. Now just change the symbols. Plus becomes, sorry, minus becomes plus. Plus becomes minus. Alternate will be cancelled. Now what is that? Plus minus. Alternate means we have to subtraction. 3 minus 2 is 1x or x. Carry is what is here? Minus 2. Now again, what is the first term here? X. And first term here? By x. X, x cancel. So what is the third term of q of x is 1. Nothing but plus 1. Now again, x into 1 is x. Minus into plus is minus. And 2 ones are 2. Now again, change the symbols. Plus becomes minus. Minus becomes plus. Plus minus and minus plus will be cancelled. Remainder is 0. So what is the g of x from this one? You can write here. Therefore, g of x is equals to x square minus x plus 1. So in the question he given p of x and q of x and r of x, we had to find g of x. So we got g of x as x square minus x plus 1. Okay, just we had to use the division algorithm. Then a remainder we changed here. Plus becomes, we brought into the LHS side. Minus becomes plus. Plus becomes minus. Then this multiplication g of x x minus 2 becomes what here? Multiplication becomes division. So after dividing, we got the g of x here. So this is about the division algorithm. Okay. So in next class, we'll see the how to find a quadratic polynomial and a cubic polynomial. Okay. So I hope you got it. Thank you so much.